So anyway, here we are in the car heading down to the smart car place. You've never driven a smart car, right?
I've never. I've only seen one in a parking lot.
Okay. So what piqued your interest about it?
I like the fact that it's small, smaller than this. This is smaller than my other car. And it gets good gas mileage. And I really like the idea of the electric one, which is the one I really want to see.
Yeah, I don't know if they have that or not, but I know they got the regular ones.
I could really, because of the fact I drive back and forth to Hollywood mostly, the electric car would work perfectly for me.
Red ones? They got black ones, they got white ones. They got every color. They have a lot of them.
Ooh, we did it.
I guess we can park anywhere, right?
Let's park in the front row. Is that how long is this?
It could be any worse than Jeff's car.
Actually, it's bigger than Jeff's car.
Okay, how much space is above your head?
Actually, pretty fair amount. I don't know if the seats are all the way up.
It's underneath your right leg. You need to adjust the seat forward or back.
But how about tilt?
Tilt? It's going to be on your left side.
Oh, it's on the left side. Oh, yeah, that's what I was doing.
Right there.
That's the right.
Right.
That's okay.
Oh, wait, you're too far forward now.
I just want to see. If you notice my car, I like to drive them up a little bit. But that's not bad now. Let's see. So, worst case, if the device fails, it's only going to here.
Yes.
It's all. I only got 27 inch legs.
So. We have a customer who's 6'9 legs.
Yeah, I'm sure he has the clearance because he probably has long legs.
Yeah.
And this is not. I like this. This is.
No, the great thing about this vehicle is that you really don't feel like you're in a smart car.
No, you know what? It feels just like my Scion. I mean, I got a Scion. It actually, it's a little wider than the Scion.
Are you ready to go?
Yeah. Now you just put it in drive, and this will sort of do its own shifting thing.
Yep. It's an automatic right now. If you want to do manual,
so it's like the Volkswagen was, where if you wanted to just run things through better steps.
Yeah. You know, if you wanted to do manual shifting, you have the paddle shifters up here, and all you have to do.
Oh, really? So this is like.
That's upshift. That's downshift.
Oh. Is it back or up forward?
Pull it towards you.
Really? We won't do anything now, right?
No, now you're
that's
in manual.
Cool. I like that.
Now to get back into automatic, hold down the right paddle shifter for a couple seconds.
This one.
Yeah.
Down, right?
Pull it back towards you. And now, see right here it says D.
Oh.
So now you're in manual.
That's cool.
And then hold it down again. Now you're back in manual. Or automatic.
Automatic. So one is let you know.
Yeah, one lets you know. And one is the gear.
Are you snapped?
I'm in.
Okay. I want those people to want to make sure. Actually, this kind of drives like Jeff's car.
What's that?
Was it Yaris? You drove the Yaris?
Oh, yeah.
It has the feel of the Yaris. This is good.
I've heard a lot of people like this vehicle better than the Yaris.
It's almost the exact same arm spread across the car as the Toyota. And I only know that because it has manual windows. It is a weird shift.
Yeah, it is. It always gets people. But you get used to it, it grows on you. We're going to stay in the right lane.
I can't see out of this mirror.
Fun to drive around.
What is it, 20-some, or what the heck is the price on this average?
You're gonna make a write up here.
Yeah.
Base price starts off at around 13,000.
Oh, really? So it's not all that bad either.
No.
But 20 would get me the thing with the air conditioning.
14.6 will get you air conditioning, radio, power windows, power mirrors.
Okay, so I can get the nice accessories, which usually do better when you sell it, actually.
Yes.
Now, is this a low enough emission vehicle? How's the emission thing? Does it qualify as a low emission vehicle?
Yes. It's just a step above the curious. Yes.
So this, I really like, I should have come over here, Bob. He already knows that my last car payment is only 2 weeks away.
Yeah, I do know that.
So how was the ride, Paul?
I really liked it. Actually, I really liked it. The ride was really firm on the butt, and that's important to me. The ride was really firm. What is this button?
Oh, there's your button.
That looks like it's off of some trim or something. You may need to hang on to that. The ride was really firm, and the feel of the steering wheel was good. And I really, when I was driving it, other than the weird shift in the transmission, which only took a few seconds to get used to, I liked it as much as my Scion.
Wow.
And the Scion for me is like the top of the car list. So I like this. Now I can see what Sherry said. See, this is so cool because of the signs. There is no way I'm not going to be able to park this.
As we leave the dealership, you know, give me your summary.
My impression is if I had this one paid off, I would buy it right now. Unfortunately, I only have the other one paid off, and I've got about 6 months worth more of payments on this, and then I have no car payment. And I really like the blue. I like the blue and the black, but I like the black better. And the thing I really liked about it is the smoothness of the ride. I can feel the difference just between this one and that one. That car was so smooth. Now, it's a new one, and this one's got 80,000, but it is so smooth, and it doesn't, even though it's a direct link steering too, I didn't feel the jerks from the road into the steering wheel.
No.
So it's really well made.